every person is walking around with this whole universe of microbes living inside them. And it's actually much more complex than your own genome. It makes it very hard to measure. And it's also very intricately related to our health.
It's really not that difficult to get data on the microbiome right now. It's difficult to do it well. And so a lot of the methods that are being used are quite prone to bias. And so the data that you get out is not necessarily an accurate reflection of the real microbiological community.
What CoreBiome does is it encapsulates everything from collecting samples through to generating the data and finding insights in the data so that people don't have to kind of figure that whole complex process out and spin it up inside their institutions.
And so being able to kind of understand the molecular biology and understand how we can process that material to make the measurements that we want and to not introduce error into those measurements, that's sort of the crux of what we do.
Our goal is to kind of set standards and to provide uniformity. So a protocol that doesn't change, for instance, a protocol that's been highly validated. So, you know, our hope is that we make the data more reproducible, but at the same time also faster and cheaper.
University of Minnesota has been a great place to start a company. I've had just nothing but great support from the Office of Technology Commercialization, my department heads, and the deans, and everybody involved.
CoreBiome would not have happened without the help of the OTC, Translational Product Development Fund, MinReach, and a lot of moral support too.
Everybody is excited because it's this new way of looking at human health and looking at drug development, and there are going to be interesting and useful clinical applications of it.